Our next inductee, Gwen Allard. You know, in today's revolution in the areas of diversity and inclusion, these changes are great. However, they would not be possible without the pioneers who have paved the way decades before. Of all of the many accomplishments we'll hear about tonight, Gwen Allard's deep, lasting legacy in the world of adaptive sports. There is no bigger visionary than Gwen Allard. Her impact is monumental because she touched the soul of the adaptive sports world and brought freedom found in skiing to the people that may have missed it because of their disabilities. Sit back, if you would, for a moment and saturate yourself in this thought. Here in Big Sky, we had a blind skier ski the Big Couloir, and it was featured on 60 Minutes. We've had sit skiers ski the Big and our other countless steeps around this resort. Vasu Santra from Bozeman, on one leg, climbed and skied Denali 2 years ago. Amazing. He's the first adaptive athlete for the North Face. Here in Big Sky, our local program, Eagle Mount, and the countless other local adaptive programs around the country change lives in the ways that we can't even imagine, because it's not a physical thing. It's a mental and spiritual change in perspective of freedom found in skiing. Of all the accomplishments of Gwen Allard, from the PSIA standards of teaching, accessibility to the lifts in the mountains, to the equipment, to how we teach,
welcome, Mom, or Gums, or
whatever.
Gwen, yes, your actual given name, Gwen. It is the middle of February on 2023, and we are here to celebrate you being voted into the Skiing Hall of Fame. It is a tremendous honor, and I think very worthy. And you have skied for 80 plus years, which is a tremendous amount of time for someone to ski.
Just time.
A lot of miles and helping thousands and thousands of people learn to enjoy snow sports. And I'm just wondering, on an occasion like this, how do you feel?
Besides old?
That's fair.
Is that fair? Yeah, I feel very old. It's gone very quickly. Mm. And I'll say this right up front. I wouldn't change one day of it. I haven't met anybody I haven't liked. I haven't met anybody who has failed. They have all given their all, the best that they could, and have been happy with their success and be able to ski. That's, they told me, I've always dreamt of this.
Yeah.
I'm just sorry it's basically stopped. I mean, the old body's given up.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
Yeah.
Because I've got those memories and they do too.
Yes.
There's no reason why people with disabilities who have had to work so hard to succeed, and they may not have gone to the top, but that's okay. They've gone down a ski hill and they have succeeded and they're happy. And I'm happy for them. They've tried so hard. They have heard no so much. No, you can't do that. And no, don't try.
And who changed their mind about that?
Oh, there's a loudmouth lady that come on, you can do it. Don't get me that way. There's no such thing as no. And they can. They can.
In honor of your mother, I'm going to call her the Freedom Fighter. Gwen Allard, having been elected by representation of the 15 million skiers and snowboarders in America, we hereby bestow upon you on this night in Big Sky, Montana, our country's highest snow sport award, the Medal of Honor, and confer upon you in her honor from this day forward, Friday, March 24th, 2023, induction into the U.S. Ski and Snowboard Hall of Fame, where you can bet her accomplishments will forever be remembered. The medal. You got it. All right.
Thank you and good evening. Can't tell you what a tremendous honor it is to stand up here and accept this award for Mom. She really wanted to be here more than anything, but unfortunately, her health made it so she couldn't. So, sorry, you're stuck with me trying to pinch it for her. I just hope I can do her some justice. When being asked to do this speech, I tried to come to the essence of Gwen. What made Mom, Mom? And it dawned on me one day, it was a conversation that I had with her many years ago. It's in June, July, something like that. We're in the kitchen, and I was doing some math homework, summer work. I was a guy that needed summer math help. I wasn't really good at it. And at about 9 or 10 years old and getting pretty frustrated, I stood up and in my best outdoor voice, I yelled, "Mom, I just can't do this. This is stupid homework." Well, the ensuing conversation is one that can only be appreciated between a parent and a child later in life. What I did get out of the conversation was that the term, "I can't do it," she wouldn't accept. She would accept, "Sorry, I'm not ready for that. Sorry, I'm not prepared. Sorry, I don't have the skills. But I can't," not in her vocabulary. I promptly told Mom, "Well, Mom, you know what? I'm not in the headspace right now to do my math homework." I lost that argument too. So when I look at her career through this lens, things start to make sense. As a young child, her mom told her, "Gwenny, little girls don't ski." Well, she had a dad that was an outdoor adventurer and a skier. She did. Later, when working at the Schenectady Ski School, she had friends that told her, "You know, Gwen, you shouldn't teach skiing. All you're going to do is going to get stuck with the kids and babysit, and the adults will be out with the guys." Well, she found her mentor in Freddie Anderson. And she did. She excelled at teaching adults. Later, in a small resort, well, I wouldn't even call it a resort, I'd call it a mountain, Round Top in Vermont, place I learned to ski and love. Her ski school director told her, Gwen, you shouldn't try and get certified. Women don't get certified. It's too difficult. You don't have the stamina. You don't understand the physics. But she did. Then a few years after that, she applied to be the executive director of the Eastern Division of PSIA. And again, she was told, Gwen, you know, that's just a good old boys club. You don't want to get involved with that. They won't respect you. They won't listen to you. Well, I can tell you that they suffered the wrath of Gwen for many years. And there are still programs that she started 20, 30 years ago that are going strong today. A few years later, she was told that veterans coming home from war and people with special needs didn't necessarily need access to buildings. It wasn't that big of a deal. Yet she had her hand in the ADA. Interesting fact about Mom. The entire time she was working on this career in raising two kids, and we weren't easy kids to raise, she had a bit of a side hustle. She was teaching on the weekends people with special needs how to ski. She was told again, it wouldn't work. People with special needs, they can stay in institutions. People that are missing legs and limbs from war, the government would take care of. She proved them wrong. She's taught thousands and thousands of people with special needs and able-bodied people how to ski, and trained thousands of people how to teach new students and carry on her legacy. She's changed the world of teaching, adaptive, and our sport, in essence. Just a few programs that she's been part of or started include Gore Mountain in New York, Ski Wyndham in the Adaptive Sports Foundation in New York again, and the latest, the Double H Hole in the Woods in Lake George, New York. Her fingerprint is on almost every adaptive program in the country. So Gwen's retired, or said she's retiring, more times than I can count. It's to the point now that every time she announces, I'm retiring from such and such a program, my brother and I look at each other and go, again, in unison. We're getting used to it. When Mom found out she was being inducted into the Hall of Fame, she was over the top excited. This has been a dream of hers forever. Then came the honest assessment of her physical abilities. The entire family pitched in and tried to figure out how to get her here. And she, in the end, made the decision that it was best that she not come. However, in typical Gwen fashion, she made it. So, in closing, from the larger adaptive community, my family, and my mom, thank you.